Hello. Welcome to Book Week Scotland at Renfrewshire Libraries. My name is Ross Collins and I'm an author and illustrator and international jewel thief. No, I'm not an international jewel thief. Pay no attention to that. I write and illustrate children's books and I am really delighted that the library has decided this week to feature my new book, There's a Mouse in My House. Now, There's a Mouse in My House is the sequel to a book that hopefully some of you guys might know. This one, There's a Bear on My Chair. I wrote this a few years ago, and ever since I wrote it, people have come up to me and said, Ross, when are you going to write There's a Mouse in My House? And the thing is, they didn't actually ask, when am I going to write the sequel? They just asked when am I going to write There's a Mouse in My House. They already knew what it was going to be called, so I thought, well, I'm going to have to call it that. So eventually I got around to it. The reason why it took me so long is because bear is a brilliant rhyme. Bear, chair, pear, layer, fair, dare, underwear. Lots of brilliant rhymes with bear, but there's not so many with mouse. Mouse is not a good rhyme. There's mouse, house, grouse, spouse, nouse. That's pretty much it. So I had to come up with a different rhyme. So I came up with a rhyme, go, as in he has to go. And that works pretty well. There's a lot of good rhymes for that. And eventually I got my head around it and wrote the book. So today, I know there's lots of other activities that the libraries have put on around the book. But today I thought I might guide you guys as to how to draw the mouse. Would you be up for that? You like to try? Okay, you need to get yourself a scrappy piece of paper, like this one, a pencil, like this one, or a pen, crayon, whatever you fancy, and get drawing. Now you might want to pause this video while you're going to get that, and maybe throughout drawing, because you may not draw as fast as I do. I draw pretty fast, because I'm a trained professional. So, shall we get going? You go. Go get your paper, go get your pens, pencils, crayons, right? Now we'll start drawing, okay? So, the mouse has a wee round head, okay? So, let's see. Wee round head, like that. Nice round head. Couple of wee hairs on the top, like that. There we go. Here he is. Okay, and he's got ears. All mice have ears. Now, the ears are great on animals. They're really good because you can show how an animal feels by the way that its ears are. If its ears are down, it's feeling quite sad. Like on Bear My Chair. Where is he? Oh, I've got my hand in front of him. Downwards ears. He's not very happy, is he? Upwards ears means happy. And in Mouse in My House, he is pretty happy because in Bear My Chair, it was the bear who had the upper hand, who was annoying the mouse. But in Mouse in My House, his ears are way up. So, got a couple of nice wee ears on there. And then expressions. What sort of expression should he have? So he's got a happy expression this time because he is very much in command. So he's got wee dots for eyes, like that. And then let's do his nose. Little mousey nose. It's like a little smiley face, a tiny wee smiley face. And then his proper mouth. So there he is, proper big mouth, big smiley mouth. And his eyebrows. If you're not happy, your eyebrows are like that. But if you're happy, they're like that. So let's do some nice expressive eyebrows. He's looking a wee bit human just now. We can change that by giving him whiskers. One, two, three, four. There we go. How's that? Now, let's draw his body. So my mouse lives where the polar bear lives. And what do we know about where polar bears live? What do we know? It's cold, isn't it? It's very cold. So my mouse wears a jumper. And I'm going to draw his arms out the way like that. Because it's a happy pose, because he is very pleased because he has moved into the bear's house and the bear can't get rid of him. Let's give him little hands, outstretched hands. He's a happy chappy. Okay? You can pause this. If I'm going too fast, pause it, do your thing, and then catch up, press play again. Okay? So, outstretched hands. Now you can just see a wee bit of his tummy underneath his jumper. And then he's got little legs. Little short, fat, hairy legs like me. Two little legs. And then he's got spindly wee feet. Like that. Not like me. I've got great big feet. A size 9, seeing as you ask. There we go. Spindly wee feet. A tail. He needs to have a tail, doesn't he? All self-respecting mice need to have a tail. So there we go. Let's draw it coming out the back, up the side. There we go, there's his tail. And I like to draw wee marks underneath the feet, and that makes it look like there's a wee bit of shadow underneath his feet. Makes him look like he's not floating. Now my mouse has a pattern jumper. So I'm going to use a red crayon. Crayons are great because they kind of look like a proper pattern on a jumper because they're all kind of rough. Like that. Look how nice and rough that is. And he's got a kind of a stripy pattern on his jumper with like triangles on it. And I got that from Icelandic pattern, a country called Iceland, where it's very cold. And they do great patterns on their jumpers. And I thought he'd have a jumper like that because he lives somewhere cold. There we go. You can do your pattern any way you want. You don't have to do my pattern. Some lines are thicker than others. Maybe he's got little blocks as well. Like that. You just make it up as you go along. Doesn't have to be red. I made it red because I wanted to make it more eye-catching. But you could make it pink or green or yellow, whatever colour you want. And you know what? Let's give him a little bit of red on his nose. There we go. Maybe even his cheeks. A bit of red in his cheeks too. So there you go. There's my mouse. I hope your mouses have turned out very well. Mouses? Is that a word? Mouses. Yeah, they're not mice. Mouses. God, it's dreadful. I've written a book about this and I don't even know how to pronounce it. Anyway, I hope your mice have all turned out really well and I hope you enjoy doing all the other activities that libraries have put on for you this week. And have a great book week, Scotland. Have lots of fun and I'll see you guys again soon. Bye-bye.